Hey guys, today I'm traveling out to the beautiful Asheville, North Carolina. We reached out to the Hearing Center of Asheville, and they've offered to run some real ear measurements on the AirPods Pro right alongside a pair of Phonak Paradise hearing aids so that we can finally know, how do AirPods Pro compare to real hearing aids? You may be asking, wait, what? AirPods Pro are hearing aids? Yeah, as surprising as it may be, AirPods Pro have recently become an option for those considering direct-to-consumer hearing amplification. Since the beginning, AirPods Pro have had a pretty neat feature called transparency mode. So this feature allowed for sound to pass through the external microphones on the outside of the AirPods Pro and into your ear. The goal was to allow you to hear outside sounds and to be more aware of your environment. The feature is super impressive and very cool, but it seemed like a logical next step for Apple to simply allow for the amplification of the sound coming into the AirPods. So in fall of 2020, Apple listened and exceeded expectations when they released iOS 14 for the iPhone. With that new release, not only did they make it possible to amplify transparency, they also added headphone accommodations. That's the game changer. It allows you to use a custom audiogram. Similar to prescription hearing aids, this allows you to correct the amplified sound according to your hearing loss. If you're interested in learning how to set these up for yourself, check the description below for a link to an instructional video. So since the release of iOS 14, there have been some pretty big questions concerning whether or not AirPods Pro can be a legitimate option for those with hearing loss. Questions like, what level of amplification do the AirPods provide? What levels of hearing loss will they work for? Will the correction provided even come close to meeting my prescription? So in this video, I hope to use real data to answer those questions. So as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, the Hearing Center of Asheville has offered to take real ear measurements on the AirPods Pro. We began by completing a new hearing test so that I would have an accurate and up-to-date audiogram on myself. Like many of you watching, I have a mild to moderate high-frequency hearing loss that is for me genetic. I've often struggled with comfort, and frankly, here in the U.S., the cost of prescription hearing aids, which is what makes the AirPods Pro as hearing aids so attractive. So now, during the real ear measurements, a thin probe microphone is inserted into my ear canal right next to the AirPods. The audiologist, Dr. Potter, is going to obtain readings of the exact sound levels I'm receiving from them while listening to a sample recording. First, we're going to run a series of measurements on the AirPods, each one with a slightly different amplification setting. Then, we're going to switch over to a pair of high-end Phonak Paradise P90 hearing aids. We're going to run the same measurements on the P90s so that we will have side-by-side data comparing the two.
So here, again, we just have a series of real ear measurements run. This is specifically the left ear currently. On the left side, in decibels, we have extremely soft sounds to extremely loud sounds, and then very low pitches or frequencies to very high frequencies. The blue line with the X's here is the hearing loss in that left ear. And essentially each one of these X's just represents the softest sound that that left ear could hear at that particular pitch. This middle dark blue line was when we measured a 55 decibel kind of speech weighted signal coming from the speakers, reaching the eardrum before any amplification or before any of the AirPods in the ear. So that we can see, kind of in the lower frequency area, that 55 decibel signal is in a nice audible range. And then as the hearing loss progresses, that same signal begins to fall below the threshold of hearing, which means obviously we need that amplification in that higher frequency range to account for that hearing loss. So one of the first measurements that we'll talk about here is this highest peak, or this dark green line. That's going to be the measurement for the Phonak Paradise, which would be called a P90R. So it's just the upper echelon of the device, and it's a rechargeable feature. So we can see that as that hearing loss begins to progress and get worse, the Phonak device is really given a lot of kind of higher frequency amplification to account for that. Not really hardly any lower frequency amplification, because obviously we didn't really need any lower frequency amplification there. The second line that we'll talk about is this purple line down here at the bottom. And basically, that's just a measure of that same 55 decibel signal with the AirPod in the ear, but turned off. So essentially functioning as an earplug. Basically, we just like to get our bearings and see where potentially it's attenuating sound and where it might be giving you a little bit of a boost because of the occlusion effect. So we see that overall, there's truly no boost at all, but it is attenuating the lower frequencies. Much less than those higher frequencies. And then we have this steeper high frequency roll off, similar to what you would get with potentially just a small roll kind of foam plug in the ear. Mm. This green line underneath of that while still is kind of a wiggly line, if you will, it's much flatter than that purple line. And that's that same 55 decibel sound with the AirPod in the noise cancellation mode there. And basically that's giving us more of a flat frequency response. So a more just overall drop in attenuation across all of the frequencies of that speech weighted sound. And then we kind of get into the amplification features of that AirPod. This kind of green line here is going to be the AirPod in the recommended amplification that you can get for the hearing loss that was inputted. You can see that comparatively, obviously, we're getting some needed amplification in relation to the hearing loss here. However, it's certainly not as much high frequency amplification as that Phonak hearing instrument. And also, we're getting some natural low frequency amplification that's basically accounting for some of that occlusion effect or plugging of the ears there. And then kind of more interestingly, when we moved on from that and saw that we weren't getting as much higher frequency amplification here, we decided then to maximize the brightness slider bar of the AirPods. And we can see that through actual kind of objective measurements that input wasn't changed too much by increasing that brightness slider. It is slightly improved in some of the higher frequencies, but even at the max brightness, it's still not nearly as much higher frequency benefit as that Phonak hearing instrument.
So the real takeaway here is that the AirPods do amplify.
Oh, they certainly do.
So there's a lot of variables there that we don't have control over.
Yep.
If that was to change in the future, maybe like if we were able to be able to create a custom audiogram for the AirPods, maybe it would get better.
There's a lot of things obviously that go into that as we were discussing earlier. One, obviously, environmental factors where you're doing the testing, mm-hmm. how those AirPods are being placed in the ear, right. And there's a lot of things. I mean, there's only so much that you can do as an individual kind of right. placing them in the ear. Yeah. So overall, I think, yes, if potentially some of the fitting and maybe the auditory evaluation right. of it was improved,
yeah.
we'd probably see an improved frequency response there, but not only in the way that they amplify or intended to amplify,
right.
But how they fit in the ear as well.
Sure,
so
yeah.
there's a lot of things there. And obviously, these are very controlled, objective mm-hmm. measurements, which generally is the gold standard for
yeah.
things.
Right.
But yeah, we'll see how it goes outside of the controlled
right.
environment as
right.
well.
Well, when you remove the professional environment and an audiologist, it leaves a pretty big margin for error.
Yeah, absolutely.
And the end user has to learn how to adjust and make these adjustments. I mean, wouldn't you say this is more well-suited for someone who has
a mild loss, yeah.
maybe moderate, but
right.
probably not enough amplification.
More so, I'd say with a mild loss.
Mild, yeah.
I don't know what the limits of the amplification mm-hmm. on that, or what the output limits mm-hmm. would be.
So this is real data. It's a base your decisions off of. So, I mean, at this point, we do know that they are actually doing what they claim to be doing, just not at the same level as, say, you know, a real pair of hearing aids, right?
Right.
Yeah. All right. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guys. So there you have it. The results are in and the AirPods performed exceptionally well. I'll be honest, even after using the AirPods as hearing aids for a while, I was surprised by the results, especially considering the hardware and software limitations of the devices themselves. By software limitations, I'm primarily referring to the limitations of the audiogram itself. When you're creating the audiogram for the AirPods, you don't have the option to input a custom audiogram. you have to use a third-party software like the Mimi app to create the audiogram directly on the phone. This has always been a major concern because there's not a controlled environment or a guarantee that the audiogram is accurate. But take a look at these results. This is a side-by-side comparison of the Mimi audiogram and the audiogram I received at the audiologist. As you'll see here, the results are strikingly similar. There are a few small differences, but these shouldn't be that noticeable when wearing the AirPods Pro as hearing aids. Note though, your mileage may vary, so when taking the hearing test in Mimi, be careful and follow the instructions. Also, and most importantly, the AirPods did perform well, but they do lack the amplification of a dedicated pair of hearing aids. This doesn't mean that they won't work for you, but if you have moderate to severe hearing loss, it's doubtful that they're going to have the level of amplification that you're going to need. Finally, if you're ready to set up your AirPods Pro as hearing aids, there's a lot of things to consider and a lot of steps to take. Be sure to click the link in the description below for the full instructional video with all the details. And to wrap up, I'd like to say thanks to the fine people at the Hearing Center of Asheville. If you happen to be in the Asheville, North Carolina area, be sure to check them out. You can also learn more about them at thehearingcenter.com. And if you enjoyed this video, the next video in this series will be a direct feature-by-feature comparison of the Phonak Paradise hearing aids and the AirPods Pro. Click the subscribe button and the notification bell to be notified when it's released. Thanks for watching.